हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू थर्ड लेक्चर ऑफ स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ एटम्स। सो इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट इलेक्ट्रॉन, डिस्कवरी ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन एंड मास ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन एंड चार्ज ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन एंड सम बेसिक डिटेल्स अबाउट ऑयल ड्रॉप एक्सपेरिमेंट। नाउ इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट अदर सब एटोमिक पार्टिकल्स, दैट मीन्स न्यूट्रॉन्स एंड प्रोटोन्स, डिस्कवरी ऑफ न्यूट्रॉन्स एंड डिस्कवरी ऑफ protons, and then we will discuss about atomic models. So in case of discovery of protons and neutrons, we used slightly modified version of a cathode ray tube which we already used in electrons. So it leads to discovery of canal rays carrying positively charged particles. Earlier we got negatively charged particles and now we are getting positively charged particle. The characteristics of these particles are mentioned below. So first point, unlike cathode rays, mass of positively charged particles depend upon the nature of gas present in the cathode ray tube. That means if you are using comparatively heavier gas, then produced positively charged particles will have comparatively more mass. In case of previous example, that means in case of electrons, all of the gases produces same type of electrons having same type of mass, but in this case we are getting different results with different gases. So these are simply the positively charged gaseous ions. That means let us assume we are using helium gas inside the tube. So when electron is separated from the helium, then you will get single electron and He plus, helium positive ion, like this. So from helium you are getting He plus and electron. So obviously mass of electron will be dependent, will be independent from the initial gas used in it. But mass of particles obtained in this case are different. That means canal rays gives different type of results with different type of gas. As for example, suppose in second case we are using hydrogen, then you will get H plus and electron. So that means this will be our canal ray in hydrogen gas and this will be our canal ray in helium gas, but both of them produces same type of cathode rays or electrons. So electrons are independent of the gas used in the tube, while canal rays depends on the gas filled in the tube. Now charge to mass ratio of particles depend on the gas from which these originated. In previous case, in case of electron, they are independent. Some of the positively charged particles carry multiple of the fundamental units of electrical discharge. That means, as for example, in case of hydrogen, we have only one proton left. In case of helium, when electron is removed, still you will get two neutrons, two protons. So that means it depends on gas used. Next point, the behavior of this particle in the magnetic or electrical field is opposite to that observed for the electrons or cathode rays. Obviously, electrons or cathode rays are negatively charged, so these particles are positively charged, so it will give us different result. So this is the simplified version of production of canal rays. So as we can see in this image, opposite situation is observed. In this case, particles are being produced from the anode side and they are moving towards the cathode side. If we poke some holes on the cathode plate and then if we cover the back side with some fluorescent material or phosphorescent material, these particles will collide with this positively charged ion. Okay, so that means when they collide with this material, it will glow red and it represents they are being produced in this case. So the smallest and lightest positive ion was obtained from obviously hydrogen and was called proton. When electron is removed from the hydrogen, only left is proton. This positively charged particle was characterized in 1919. Later a need was felt for the presence of electrically neutral particle as one of these constituent of atom. This particle was discovered by Chadwick by bombarding thin sheet of beryllium by alpha particles. And alpha particles are
It contains two neutrons and two protons. That means we can say that it is the nucleus of helium. When electrons are removed from the helium, two neutrons and two protons will be left. During the radioactive activity, these type of alpha particles produced. So when he bombarded the thin sheet of beryllium with alpha particle, electrically neutral particles having slightly more mass than protons are being produced or emitted. He named those particles neutrons because they are neutral by charge. They do not have any type of charge. And in this table, some basic details of these fundamental particles are mentioned. So as for example, electron symbol E, proton P and neutron N. So charges of electrons and protons are exactly the same but opposite with sign. Electrons are negative and protons are positive, while neutrons are completely neutral. So relatively, electrons are considered as minus one charge, protons plus one, neutrons zero. Now in case of mass, electrons are lightest. Okay, 9.1093 into 10⁻³⁻¹ kilograms, whereas protons are comparatively far more heavier than the electrons, and neutrons are slightly heavier than protons. So relative mass 0.00054 1.00727 and 1.00861. So that we can consider electron as a 1 and neutrons and protons, electrons as 0, neutrons and protons as 1, 1. Now next topic is atomic model. So we have multiple different type of atomic models. In initial time, scientists discovered different type of atomic models, but they have some mistakes in them. So step by step, later scientists corrected them and eventually, finally, we found perfect structure of atom. Now, Dalton's atomic theory was not able to explain certain practicals we discussed earlier. Why positive particles are generated or why negative particles are generated. According to Dalton, atoms are indivisible, but as per these practicals result, we can say that they are divisible, they have some subatomic particles. So if they have some subatomic particles, then we have some other issues, and issues are mentioned below. So let us discuss. So first is to account the stability of atom. If it contains neutral, positive and negative atoms, then how it can be stable? That means if as mentioned earlier, like charges repels each other and unlike charges attracts each other, then electron and proton should attract each other and they should be mixed with each other. Instead, electrons and protons are separate from each other in atoms and still atomic structure is stable. Next, to compare the behavior of element in term of both physical and chemical properties. If all of them contains these type of subatomic particles, that means same type of subatomic particles, then how they are distinguished from each other. Then is explain the formation of different kind of molecule by the combination of different atoms, and to understand the origin and nature of the characteristics electromagnetic radiation absorbed or emitted by atoms. Now substance do absorb or emit electromagnetic radiation. Now what is electromagnetic radiation? In simple thing, we can say that electromagnetic radiation is light. As for example, we can see things with the help of light. When light is impacted on something and then it will reflect from that thing and it will eventually reaches to the eye, then we can see the substance. Now light is one type of electromagnetic substance. Electromagnetic radiation. We have many other type of electromagnetic radiation which are not visible, as for example infrared or microwaves, radio waves, ultraviolet rays, x-rays, etc. They are not visible for us. We can only see a very small portion of electromagnetic radiation known as visible light. So atoms can absorb these type of electromagnetic radiation, okay, or it can emit these type of electromagnetic radiation. Certain substance can glow. So when they are glowing, it represents they are emitting some kind of energy, which is electromagnetic radiation. So different type of models were proposed to explain these type of phenomenon as well as distribution of positive negative particles in atom, but they were not able to explain stability of atoms. Two of this model, one proposed by J.J. Thomson and other proposed by Ernest Rutherford, are discussed below. So according to J.J. Thomson's model, he proposed that atoms are spherical in shape and diameter is 10 raised to minus 10 meters, in which the positive charge is uniformly distributed. That means we can say that we have a round, globe shaped vessel in which we filled liquid. Let us assume this liquid is positively charged. The electrons are embedded into it in such manner as to give the most stable electrostatic arrangement. That means electrons are equally distributed in whole region of globe. So as mentioned here, so this whole globe or a spherical shape sphere represents positivity, and we have some electrons embedded in it equally distributed, so that positive and negative charge is completely balanced. So just like as mentioned in the names, plum pudding or raisin pudding, or more familiar for us, watermelon. So just like seeds present in watermelon, seeds represents electron, and whole watermelon we can assume it as a positive sphere. So this model is able to explain overall neutrality, why atoms are neutral, but we have some other issues with this type of model. And these issues are some experiments which we are going to discuss later. So Thomson was awarded Nobel Prize of Physics in 1906 for his theoretical and experimental investigation on the conduction of electricity by gas. Now next is Rutherford's nuclear model of atom. So Rutherford and his student Hans Geiger and Ernst Marsden bombarded very thin gold foil with alpha particle. Alpha particle, that means, as mentioned, nucleus of helium, two protons and two neutrons bunch. So Rutherford's famous alpha particle scattering experiment is mentioned here. So this is the practical. Here we have source of alpha particle. It is a radioactive substance which emits alpha particle, bunch of two neutrons and two protons. Then we placed a lead plate. Lead is one of the most dense metal, so it will act as filter. If we have comparatively higher amount of produced alpha particle, it will filter out and it will let some of them pass through it. Okay, so that means it will act as a filter. Then we have our gold plate having 100 nanometer thickness, and it is surrounded by photographic plate. So when alpha particle is produced from the source, then filtered by lead plate, and when these particles collide with gold plate, majority of these particles pass through it without any kind of deflection. Very few of them are deflected and they will collide with photographic plates, and some of them will bounce back. Very small amount will bounce back. So what this practical represents, if structure of atom was as mentioned before, that means if it is like watermelon, then it should deflect or reflect all of this particle, or at least majority of this particle. But most of the particles are able to pass through it. Most of the alpha particles are able to pass through it. That means it contradicts with plum pudding or watermelon models. If it is like watermelon model, that means if it is a solid mass of positive charge, then applied alpha particle should deflect like this. But instead of deflection, most of them are able to pass through it, and very small amount is being deflected. When alpha particle collide with photographic plate, it will emit lights. So we can identify the amount of deflected particle. So now result of the scattering experiment were quite unexpected. As mentioned, if it is like, if atomic structure is like plum pudding model or watermelon model, then most of them should deflect. Instead, majority are able to pass through it. So according to Thomson's model, the mass of each gold atom in the foil should be have been spreaded evenly over the entire atom. And the alpha particle had enough energy to pass directly through such uniform distribution of mass. It was expected that the particles would slow down and change direction only by a small angle and they pass through the foil. It was observed that most of them pass through the gold foil undeflected, that means without any change in direction. A small fraction of alpha particles was deflected by small angle and very few, 1 in 20,000 bounced back, that is were deflected by nearly 180 degree. So on the basis of the observation, Rutherford drew the following conclusion regarding the structure of atom. Most of the space in atom is empty as most of the alpha particles passed through the foil undeflected. Few positively charged alpha particles were deflected. The deflection must be due to the enormous repulsion force, showing that the positive charge of atom is not spread through the atom as the Thomson has presumed. The positive charge has to be concentrated in a very small volume that repelled and deflected the positive charged alpha particle. And lastly, calculation by Rutherford shows that the volume occupied by nucleus is negligibly small as compared to the total volume of atom. The radius of the atom is about 10 raised to minus 10 meters, while that of the nucleus is 10 raised to minus 15 meters. One can appreciate this difference in size by realizing that if size of atom is equal to cricket ball, then radius of atom will be 5 kilometers. They have large difference in them. So this is a result of experiment. Most of the alpha particles are passed through the gold foil without any deflection. Very small amount is deflected and extremely small amount is being reflected, that means bouncing back at 180 degree angle. So on the basis of above's conclusion, Rutherford gave us some points indicating the structure of atom. So first point, positive charge and most of the mass of atom was densely concentrated in the extremely small region. This very small portion of the atom was called nucleus by the Rutherford. When nucleus is surrounded by electrons that moves around the nucleus with very high speed in circular paths called orbit. Thus, Rutherford's model of atom resembles a solar system, which we studied in earlier standards. Okay, so in which nucleus plays the role of sun and electrons are revolving planets around it. And last point, the electrons and neutrons nucleus are held together by electrostatic force of attraction. Still, this structure of atom contains some limitations.